Hello mga kapuso, so it's week 786 ng quarantine. Kita nyo, iba na ang itsura ko, meron na akong pabalbas. Sa mga nakakaalam sa inyo, ako ay college student pa rin. So nag-start ako ng college 2009 at ngayon 2020 na. Dami nang nangyayari sa mundo pero hindi pa rin ako graduate. Kaya tinatapos ko yung online course ko. I am going to finish my last subject and it's called chemistry. At since syempre lockdown ngayon or enhanced community quarantine, kailangan namin mag-conduct ng mga lab experiment sa bahay. At hindi ako magsisinungaling. Halos close to none ang alam ko sa mga chemistry So itong vlog na to parang chemistry for dummies. Yan ang aking itatakil ngayon dahil ako ay gagawa nga ng experiment that anybody can do using common household liquids. So ang gagawin natin ay itetest natin ang pH level. Okay, ano ba yung pH level? Ang pH level ay... nakalagay sa Google, I'm not gonna pretend that I know. pH level is a measure of how acidic slash basic water is. The range goes from 0 to 14, with 7 being neutral. pH of less than 7 indicate acidity, whereas pH of greater than 7 indicate as a base. So ayan, nakitang-kita nyo mga kaibigan. Medyo konti lang naintindihan ko doon, I'm not going to lie. So yan yung gagawin ko. So I have a couple of compounds or household liquids nga dito na nakita ko around. And I'm going to test and get the pH levels of each. Pakita ko sa inyo ngayon kung ano yung mga yan. So I'm going to make calamansi juice, salt solution, may fruit juice dito, may white vinegar, gagawa rin ako ng baking soda solution, at pH care sa akin po yan. Okay, tapos ito ang mga measuring cup na gagamitin ko. So ito 60 ml, tapos cleaning liquid. So katulad nga na sinabi ng chemistry prof ko, I need to have a red cabbage. Ang red cabbage raw kasi ay natural indicator. So hahaluan ko yon ng tubig tapos i-blender ko, and then hahaluan ko ng mga compounds na ito. So kapag nag-iba yung kulay base sa graph na gagamitin ko, doon mag-i-indicate ng level of pH ang makukuha ko. Tapos ililista ko, tapos na po yung experiment. So samahan niyo ako mga kaibigan as I teach you chemistry for dummies. So yes mga kaibigan, nandito nga po ako ngayon sa kusina namin. At katulad ng sinabi ko sa inyo, kailangan ko ng red cabbage. This is a red cabbage. It's apparently a natural indicator of pH levels. Ang gagawin ay chop-chopin to, tapos i-blender ko. Okay, so tapos na. Na-chop-chop ko na. Next step is to put it in a blender with 500 ml of distilled water. This is 500 ml of distilled water. And I will put the red cabbage. Science! Look at me. Pwede na ako mag-scientist. Para maramdaman ko yung full experience of being in a lab, kailangan ko magsuot ng mga latex disposable gloves. Kahit mga red cabbage lang naman ang aking inimix. Alright, you guys ready? Here we go, blending the red cabbage. 3, 2, 1.
Ano yung aircon?
Sige, please. Hi, baby!
Hi!
So, nagkamali ako. I missed out the part where the water should be one. Okay, take two. Take two! Warm water! Red cabbage! Let's go! 2 minutes on the clock. 1, 2, 3, go! Okay, 2 minutes. Para na siyang juice, oh. Alright, so since wala akong strainer, I will be using just a simple cloth to extract the juice from the compound that I made. So let's do that. Whoa! Sana gumana. Science for dummies. Tapon ko na to. Huwag niyo sasabihin kay Joyce at tinapon ko yung telo mo. But I have no choice. So what I am going to do, ang first step dito ay place about 10 ml of distilled water in a glass container and label. Add 5 ml to the extract solution and observe the color. 10 ml is, so this is 60 ml. So I'm guessing it's probably 1 teaspoon. Or nakalagay dito, 10 ml is equal to 0.67 teaspoon. So parang basically 3/4. Huwag niyo akong i-correct sa mata. Disclaimer, lahat artista po ako. At host, hindi po ako chemist or mathematician, kaya huwag niyo po ako i-bash dahil sa mga pagkakamali ko. I'm doing my best. Okay, 10 ml of distilled water. Hold on. Lagyan natin sa cup. Okay, so una ang itong water. Probably around 10 ml na ito. And then 5 ml. Siguro ang 5 ml is kalahating teaspoon. Ano mangyayari? Whoa! Ano dun sa purple? As you can see, it's kind of purplish. Light purple, hindi naman siya indigo. So it's a 7. And is water a base? pH level of 7. Okay, so panalo. This is a base. Water is a base. Alright. Light purple. Moving on. Let's now go to white vinegar. 10 ml ang sabi nila. But we'll just try to estimate, okay? Alright, so I think that's 10 ml. Asim! Ayan, ano ba ang pH level ng white vinegar? Wow! Look at that! Science! Wow! Nasa pink eh, no? Ayan, no? Dark pink siya. Wow! So, vinegar is acid! Dark pink. Estimated pH level 2. Alright, okay, next. Okay, so ang next na compound na aking ina-measure ng pH level ay ang feminine wash, okay? 10 ml of this. That's probably 10 ml. I have no idea. And then 5 ml of this red cabbage extract. Whoa, look at that. Parang medyo nabubuo siya, oh. So as you can see, mga kaibigan, it's just purple. Ibig sabihin, this is pH balanced. Katulad ng mga claim nila. So this is purple. pH level 6, feminine wash. Violet, acidic. Okay, on to the next one. Alright, the next homemade or commercial product I'm going to use is juice. Fruit juice, to be exact. Tingnan natin. This is actually guyabano juice. Diretso ko na lang dito. And then, what is the pH level of guyabano juice? Wow! Cut that. Well done. I'll show you. Guyabano juice is pink. Acidic. Ah, dahil sa mga ano niya, sweeteners. So it's acidic. Alright, so ano papansin ko sa experiment ko, I have done 3 products already, white vinegar, the feminine wash, and fruit juice. They are all, in my experiment, acidic. Okay, so ito, ang balita ko dito sa next na product natin. O, di ba parang nag-host? This is for sure going to be a basic solution. This is bleach. So, it should turn out to be parang bluish. Titingnan natin. So, let's do it. Yeah! Okay, so this is bleach. And titingnan natin kung ano magiging kulay. Ready? Whoa! It's green! Light green! Ibig sabihin, this has a strong base. So this is a base solution. First in our experiment, and then we put bleach green. So that's pH level 12, and that is a base. Wonderful. So I have probably 2 more to go para matapos ko na to. Okay, so stick around. So ang next na ingredient or ng commercial product natin gagamitin is the salt solution. So I already made the salt solution. Here it is. Let's find out what the pH level is. Whoa! Wow! Ah, it's basic. Salt solution is basic. It's blue. Ito na yan. Science! Salt solution. Blue. 10. So it's blue and estimated pH value is around 10. So that is a base. Wow. I am shocked. Galing. Alright, for this round naman, imi-measure ko ang pH level ng calamansi. Since I don't have calamansi juice, this is what I'll use. Calamansi extract. Okay, so let's see how that goes. Wow! Sobrang different color niyo. It is... What color is this? Indigo? Medyo color blend nga ako. I think it's pink. It's dark pink. So, okay. So, base sa experiment ko, I think this is an acid. And it is some sort of strong acid. Interesting. We learn something new every day. Alright mga kaibigan, I am down to my last solution. So this is baking soda solution. So I will measure how acid or basic this is by getting the pH level of it. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Oh my gosh, that is just amazing. Look at it, it's clearly green, diba? Okay, so tapos na ako sa aking experiment. Since this is green, it's apparently 12. It's a strong base. And it is pH level 12. Grabe, ang taas. 12, green, amazing base. All in all, my theory is, at huwag niyo ako i-judge, apparently, ako kapag narinig mo yung acid, ganyan, parang delikado ilagay sa katawan, or kapag narinig mo yung basic, parang harmless lang, i-digest or what. Apparently, base sa experiment na ginawa ko, baliktad pala siya. Okay, so ang hypothesis ko dito, base sa data na nakuha ko, the neutral, the more neutral it is, pwedeng ilagay or pwedeng i-digest at pwedeng matolerate ng ating mga katawan. For example, ito white vinegar, strong acid siya, it has a pH rating of 2, so hindi mo siya pwedeng, pwede naman, pero mapakla, it's safe naman. But on the other hand, kapag strong base siya, like baking soda and bleach, of course, definitely, you don't need a scientist to tell you that you should not digest it. Ang water has yung pH level of 7, so it's neutral, so it's perfectly okay for the body. Okay, tapos na ako. I hope you did enjoy this uncharacteristic vlog that I have made for you guys. Sana may natutunan kayo. Sana tuloy pa rin kayong manood at mag-subscribe sa lahat ng mga pinaggagawa ko in life. So again, this is quarantine day 6573.2, and I'm signing out. Please click like and subscribe. Babu.